So guys, welcome back to 91 Wheels for the all the updates from the motor show. The madness continues. It's Monday today. It's a public day. And at this time, we want to speak to one of the most important names behind GWM. That's a very important name at the expo. Great Wall Motors. Kaushik, thank you for being here. The first question, how is the response from the Auto Expo?
Well, we are actually quite overwhelmed with the response. So as you would know, we launched our brands here. This was the first interaction with India. We kind of told the Indian consumers which brands we would have in future in India. In fact, even today, being a Monday, you can see it's quite crowded.
Right.
I guess it's also got to do a lot with the curiosity which people have with the GWM name, because you know, I guess there is some kind of anticipation. So the models which we displayed here are more or like representative of what kind of models which we have.
Right.
And I mean, I can see going around, people are quite excited.
Right.
The type of models, whether a design, feature or the interiors,
right,
quite good response really.
Right. And if I'm not wrong, the manufacturing will happen at Talegaon in Maharashtra?
That's right. So last month we had an MOU signing with the GWM Motors. And sometime this year, in the second half of this year, we'll have handover of the plant from GWM Motors, the Talegaon plant.
Okay.
The car plant presently manufactures small cars, so we'll have kind of modify it to suit our requirements. In 2021 is when we expect to roll out the first model out of that plant itself.
And the first model will be an SUV or an EV?
It would definitely be an SUV.
Right.
But okay, let me kind of clarify here.
Yes.
So we launched two brands here. One is the Haval brand, which is our SUV brand,
right,
and the other is a GWM EV brand.
Yeah.
Having said that, there is a lot of electrification in the Haval SUV also.
Okay.
Basically, which means that the Haval SUVs are SUVs, you know, as a vehicle type, but which have options of the traditional fuel as well as hybrids, plug-in hybrids, and pure electric vehicles as well.
Right.
So the first model or the first brand to be launched would be under the Haval.
Okay.
Thereafter, we would launch models under the GWM EV brand. So the GWM EV brand essentially would be pure electric vehicles, which are not SUVs. So that's kind of the distinction.
Right. And you use the words traditional fuels for the SUVs. Now, I'm an SUV lover, and I want my SUVs to have ample torque that comes from a diesel. So are you guys BS6 ready for diesel as well in India?
So in China, our models are already conforming to China 6 to kind of give you an indication. And in terms of the specifications, China 6 and BS6 are pretty much similar.
Okay.
That's to start with. However, at the moment, I would not like to comment on whether diesel, whether petrol, whether etc. Because when we're nearer to the launch, we'll kind of share more, speak more about the model. And the powertrain as well.
So. Right. And for the EV brand, now there's a lot of work to be done in India from the infra point of view, from the government supporter point of view. Of course, manufacturers are doing their bit. What are your plans in short to develop an ecosystem around charging infrastructure to basically remove the rain anxiety?
So, I actually have a very contrarian view to it. The fact is, world over, if you see EVs or electric vehicle users, even in countries where charging facility is quite widely available, there is a study which shows about 3/4 of the consumers actually charge their vehicle overnight at their home.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Wow. So, though they want the peace of mind that they have the option if they need to, but actual usage is actually more of a kind of overnight charging.
Okay.
Having said that, yes, India needs to go a lot ahead in terms of the infrastructure, but I believe it's not just the government's duty. It's also the manufacturers like us who need to bring in more models, firstly, for people to consider. If you look at the Indian market right now, there are very few electric vehicle options available if one really goes out to buy. So it is, of course, we consider our responsibility as well to offer more options to the customers.
Yes.
Our focus when we look at the EVs in India would be on a technology disruption, which basically means we would have a strong focus on the energy density of the battery, long-range vehicles, which gives a peace of mind to consumers.
Right.
So we're speaking of ranges of upward of 350, 400 kilometers, which in a way you can say that kind of takes care of the urban commuters' 5 to 7 days requirements.
Right.
So once these kind of models are there in the market, I believe the anxiety would be far less from the consumers. However, I believe that, you know, the next few years, it would still, the private adoption of electric vehicles would still be more of a niche kind of area. So we would have two kind of vehicles under the EV. So one kind would be addressed to the mobility solution needs, whatever their needs are in terms of, you know, compact size, big space,
right,
or bigger vehicles,
right,
higher range, smart solutions, safe vehicles. So the focus would be on that. And parallelly, we would also have solutions for the private buyer, so private mobility, which to start with, I can share you, this would be a very high-end electric vehicle.
Where would the R1 fit in?
So I'm not saying that the R1 would be here in India, for that matter. Why we displayed the R1 and the other model called IQ here is just for representative purpose,
right,
to begin with.
Right.
And we have a whole lot of other electric vehicles coming up in China. In fact, in China, there is as a separate company, Great Wall has a joint venture with BMW.
Oh, wow.
The company, the project is called Spotlight.
Okay.
So that, it's a separate company, it's a joint venture company. So as part of that, Great Wall is actually kind of developing electric vehicles for BMW for the Mini range. So
oh,
the
okay.
Mini electric, which you might be kind of hearing,
yes,
BMW,
yes,
is coming up with.
So before we end, Kaushik, I'm sure people want to take up your dealerships and we want to know your network in the next few years. What are your initial plans?
Since you asked, we are actually swamped with inquiries right from the first day, whether at the expo or whether otherwise. So our network strategy would essentially follow the products.
Okay.
Because we have a lineup of products one by one in a certain pace. And certain products we believe would go into more into certain kind of markets. So let's say to start with, we would have network in the tier 1 and tier 2 cities for
right.
sure.
Okay.
Then the network density and city coverage we would keep expanding,
okay,
following the product strategy.
Okay. Okay. Awesome. Thank you much.
Thank you
so much.